Welcome back to First Things First. Undisputed coming up at 9:30 sharp. Jenny, we warmed you up. We give it to you. What are you and the guys talking about today?
Good morning, Jenna. Yes, great show so far this morning. Coming up on Undisputed, we have a loaded Friday. Are the Chargers now the favorites in the AFC after their big win last night? Did James Harden make a statement against LeBron and the Lakers? And will the Cowboys keep rolling on Sunday? We'll discuss all that. Plus, Eric Dickerson, Steven Jackson, and Rob Parker are in studio. We've got a busy day. Happy Friday, guys. Hope you have a great weekend.
Yeah, you do. We look forward to that, Jenny. Thank you. Time for us here to go viral on First Things First. Last night, James Harden went off. 50 points he put up against the Lakers. He was dunking on folks, hitting step back threes, baiting people into fouls, everything. Maybe he got extra hyped up from his pregame outfit.
Come on, man.
It is out of control.
Come on, James. Like, I'm all for the new age of NBA style. I think Russ has some really interesting style. But LeBron with the suit with shorts was a bad look. And this is somehow a worse look.
That's like a snake pattern.
I mean,
I don't know what the temperature. I don't know what the temperature was yesterday in Houston, but I hope it was warm enough.
Why to be that warm. Is the
Hold
fact
on.
That
How do I am the only
are...
one? This is the only Photoshop y'all do that Jenny and Chris aren't a part of.
Because you like the outfit.
I don't like the outfit, first
the
of all.
The socks being baggy are my favorite part of it.
Whose legs are those?
I seen those guys last night on Canal Street.
Whose are those?
My brother, do I got an outfit for you?
This is...
You do look tall, though.
I am tall, Sorry. And I am a little thin.
Oh, they did boost your height.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not 6'7", as that picture would intimate.
Yeah, I don't know who they got the body from, but those kneecaps is weak.
I mean, what's happening there? There's no way to end the week, y'all.
Best Man, way to end.
You look like a 90-year-old white guy on the beaches of Florida with them socks and legs.
Yeah, I do. And that's not my brand, see?
Yeah, we know.
Back to last night's game. Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs facing off against Phillip Rivers and the Chargers. We picked this up in the fourth, less than 4 minutes to go. Chargers down 14. Justin Jackson in for the score, cuts the lead to 7. Chiefs have a chance to put it away, but Mahomes takes the sack. Chargers get the ball back. Phillip Rivers connects on the 31-yard pass. For pass interference. Next play, Rivers to Mike Williams in the end zone. That is a touchdown. Chargers say, we're not tying it up. We're going to go for the win. They decide to go for two, and they make it. Rivers finds Williams again. Chargers win 29-28 to improve to 11-3. Here's head coach Anthony Lynn on the decision to go for two at the end.
We came here to tie. We came here to win. And so to me, it was a no-brainer.
I was going to the sideline, going to overtime. And Coach Lynn said, let's go win it right now. Let's go for two. Let's go win it right now. And when he said that, there was so much conviction from him. It was, yeah, let's go win it right now. I mean, it was immediately turn around, let's go win it. I mean, and if we didn't win it, we didn't win it. But I think his conviction, it wasn't like, should we? It wasn't. It was, no, let's go win the game.
There's not much you have to say. I mean, everybody feels that feeling. I mean, they want to get back out there tomorrow. So we're going to have a long 10 days. We're going to Seattle, which, I mean, it's a tough place to play. They're playing really good football right now. And so we're going to just recuperate, see what we did well and see what we didn't do so well, and find ways to use this as fuel as to go out there and win these next two games and then get into the playoffs.
All right, CeCe, what did you make a decision for the Chargers to go for two?
I thought it was a good decision. I wasn't shocked by them going for two. Now, if this was 5 years ago, I would have been shocked. I'd have been like, whoa, unless you're Bill Belichick, he's far more aggressive in big games like this, especially against an offense that's as explosive as them. I wouldn't want to go to overtime and lose the toss and, man, not even get a chance to get on the field. So I really respect him going for it in this day and age. Teams are doing it. On the road, you go for the win. At home, you play for the title. tie. Big win by the Chargers, being able to make that huge comeback at the end. So I like the fact that Phillip Rivers, too, just a small little point. He talked about, because a veteran, he's been in the league 15 years. In that situation, we've heard all kinds of things, what the quarterback was thinking. Ben Roethlisberger's the best. On this one, I was like, go for two. He came off, he was like, whatever the coaches want. He's like, Coach Lynn, he said, go for it. And I was like, let's go for it.
And guess what? What Anthony Lynn was, it was communicating to him there and what he had communicated to his team on that drive. When we score, we're going for this.
Yes. He told
everyone's
the coordinator,
on the same page.
He told the coordinator, Wisenhunt, to get your two-point play ready.
It wasn't reactionary.
Right, yes.
It was a plan. And we on Twitter, when I say we, me and my internet friends were discussing this on Twitter last night, that as soon as the Chiefs punted the ball, as soon as the Chargers forced that key three and out that you showed in the highlight, we thought that if they scored, they would go for two. Because there were a lot of factors, a lot of reasons to it. One, the Chargers defense was slicing up the Chargers offense, slicing up the Chiefs even second half. Two, because we're this late in the season, we know what a tie's value really is as far as this race. For the Chiefs, a tie would have been as good as a win because teams are chasing them. They just have to avoid losses. For the Chargers, a tie would have been as bad as a loss as far as catching the Chiefs. So if they do kick the extra point, there's a little extra math you got to go through there, which is Kansas City might be a little more deliberate, might be a little slower because they don't have to win the game. They can try to squeeze out that 10 lose. Minutes on the clock. All of those reasons make it to where this was the absolute right decision. And I just hope folks that are going to be congratulating Anthony Lynn today on jobs like this wouldn't be killing him if Mike Williams had dropped that ball or if the Chiefs had gotten to Phillip Rivers. It was the right call, irrespective of how it finished. Like, absent of the result, it was the right call. But the bigger picture is, see, 2 weeks ago, the Chargers were on the road in Pittsburgh, down 16 in the second half, and they won. This week, they're on the road in Kansas City, down 14 in the fourth quarter, and they won. This is a team that was
in Pittsburgh and Kansas City. Those are two of the five toughest places to play in the NFL the last 40 years. Not the last four games, but the last 40 years. Those two places, those are two of the more impressive. We saw Pittsburgh, never been done in franchise history. And last night was just as impressive what they did in KC.
And I know Pittsburgh now, we're like, oh, how good are they? One of the reasons we're questioning Pittsburgh is because of what the Chargers did to them.
Of course.
Kansas City, the best record in the conference. What they've done, they didn't have Melvin Gordon. Keenan Allen got knocked out early. Like, they weren't a full-strength unit, and they were still able to do this.
And they were down. They were trailing by 14.
And which is what makes it so impressive. So the Chargers, now they still got work to do to get the one seed or to even win the division. But if they do, they are as dangerous as any team in the AFC.
All right, so let's look on the other side. What was your takeaway from the Chiefs after this loss?
Well, you can't depend on their secondary. You can't depend on them coming down the stretch. You depend on them to make a play. On the one pass interference in the end zone, for fans who thought the flag came in late, it was a questionable call. The flag did come in late, but anytime you go for a ball, especially on the end line where the back judge is close to you, and you can only get one hand up and you can see your other hand.
Both teams, just like I said to Philly fans a few weeks ago, I'm going to say to Chiefs fans this week, zip it on the officials. I understand. You could say, there were these bad calls against the Chiefs. The Chiefs' final scoring drive, there were about three bad calls against the Chargers that extended it. I didn't think it was a great night for the officials, but it didn't benefit one team greater than the other. The reason this loss is potentially has a bigger effect than just one loss for the Chiefs is they can still get the one seed. In fact, if they go 2-0, they will get the one seed. But it pierces whatever sense of invulnerability they had in that building. Mm-hmm. And it is for the fans, you felt the fans were waiting for the other shoe to drop as soon as they punted after that three and out. You don't want that feeling in that building in a playoff.
We talked about Wisenhunt having a plan if they were going to score. The head coach had told him we're going to go for two. Andy Reid did not have a plan on that four-minute drive of how to run out that clock. Because why? You go off left tackle. You run an inside run out of a spread formation. You are not trying to eat up the clock. You are grabbing at straws. You get your heavy formation. You put two or three tight ends in, and you run the ball. If you're going to throw it, you throw it through play action on first down. So, for me, they got a running back problem. Since Kareem Hunt is not on the team, how are they going to utilize the position, and do they have confidence in going forward? To me, that's an issue that the Chiefs are going to have to be able to solve.